Welcome to three examples of determining limits involving an absolute value function. We'll first determine these limits graphically, then determine the limits algebraically. Notice all three limits involve the absolute value function, f of x equals 4 times the absolute value of the quantity x plus 3 divided by the quantity x plus 3. So for the first example, we have the limit as x approaches 1 of the absolute value function. Well, notice here's where x equals positive 1. And as we approach positive 1 from the right, or the positive side, the limit is equal to positive 4. And as we approach positive 1 from the left side or negative side, we're also approaching the function value of positive 4. Therefore, this limit is positive 4. Next, we have the limit as x approaches negative 3 of the absolute value function. Notice x equals negative 3 is where we have the discontinuity. And as we approach negative 3 from the positive side or right side, notice how we're approaching positive 4. But as we approach negative 3 from the left side or negative side, we're actually approaching a function value of negative 4. Because these one-sided limits are not equal to each other, the limit as x approaches 3 of our function does not exist. Notice the next limit is a one-sided limit. We have this little plus sign here to the right of the 3. So this is the limit as x approaches negative 3 from the positive side or right side of our function. So if we're only approaching from the right side or positive side, we're only approaching from this side here. And therefore, this one-sided limit does exist. It's equal to positive 4. Now let's take a look at these limits again algebraically. The key to determining these limits algebraically is to write the given absolute value function as a piecewise defined function. Looking at just the absolute value part of this function, notice as long as x is greater than negative 3, the value inside the absolute value would be positive, and therefore we would not need the absolute value. So again, as long as x is greater than negative 3, we can just drop the absolute value and say the function would be equal to 4 times the quantity x plus 3 divided by the quantity x plus 3. And notice in this form, x plus 3 over x plus 3 would simplify out, giving us the constant function f of x equals 4. Again, as long as x is greater than negative 3. Next, notice that x equals negative 3 is not in the domain of this function. So now we'll consider when x is less than negative 3. Notice when x is less than negative 3, we'd have a negative number inside the absolute value, but the absolute value would make it positive. Which means when x is less than negative 3, we'd have to take the opposite of the quantity x plus 3, so it would equal the absolute value of x plus 3. So the opposite of 4 times the quantity x plus 3 would be equal to 4 times the absolute value of the quantity x plus 3 when x is less than negative 3. So for the second piece, we have a negative sign here. We drop the absolute value. And again, notice how we have the quantity x plus 3 over the quantity x plus 3 simplifying out. So when x is less than negative 3, we have the constant function f of x equals negative 4. So now looking at these three limits one more time, as x approaches positive 1, well, that occurs when x is greater than negative 3, and the function is continuous over this entire interval. And therefore, as x approaches positive 1 from the right and the left, we would be approaching the value of positive 4. Next, as we approach negative 3, that's where we have a break in the graph. So let's take a look at both one-sided limits from the right and left of negative 3. As we approach negative 3 from the positive side, that's when x is greater than negative 3. We'd be approaching the function value of positive 4. But as we approach negative 3 from the negative side, that's when x would be less than negative 3. We'd be approaching negative 4. Because these one-sided limits are not equal, this limit would not exist. And then finally, we have the limit as x approaches negative 3 from the positive side of our function. Well, from the positive side would be when x is greater than negative 3 here. And therefore, the function value would be approaching positive 4. So it's a little more difficult to determine these types of limits algebraically, but I think it's helpful to understand how to do this both graphically and algebraically. I hope you found this helpful.